Hello, it's Metal Matt again. You may have saw me on the other ABBA reaction video. If you didn't, well, hello. I'm not an ABBA fan. I'm a Metalhead, and I do like a lot of 80s pop, but I never really got into ABBA. Just not my cup of tea. But they're back, so how could I resist listening to their new stuff for the first time ever? Someone in the comments of the last episode, or last reaction, if you want to call it that, said I ought to listen to this song I'm about to listen to now, which is Don't Shut Me Down, because it sounds more like classical ABBA. So that is why I am here, because I want to see, compare it to the old classical ABBA. I'm very intrigued to whether they can still sort of sound like they did. And the last song, which I reacted to, which was I Still Have Faith in You, I found was kind of there were similarities to the classical ABBA, but I could tell the age in the voice and different things like that. So this time I'm very intrigued to see whether it really is close to the old stuff. So here we go. I've got Don't Shut Me Down, and yeah, let's go.
The sound of children's laughter. Now it's quiet, so I guess they left the park.
It's more of a
This
lyric
wooden
video, this
bench
one.
is getting harder by the hour. The sun is going down, it's getting dark. I realize I'm cold. The rain begins to pour as I watch the windows on the second floor. The lights are on, it's time to go. It's time at last to let him know.
There we go. I was wondering for a second, and then it's kicked in. Yeah, this is sounding a bit more classic, ABBA. Yeah, I prefer this one for sure. Quite a cool lyric video. It's kind of like a space and quite a good visuals, you know. But yeah, nice vocals. That sounds very, very like the older ABBA stuff. Classic sounding. I think depending on the key they sing, it's kind of there's hints of the older, like them being old in like when they're singing a bit lower, but when they hit that same key which they're hitting about now, you're hearing that classic ABBA sound, especially with the music, you know, the piano bits, and this bit's quite groovy. Yeah, I quite like that bit. Haven't gathered what the song's about yet. It's some kind of love story by the sound of it. Nice tones to the voice. Quite like the feel of it, yeah. You know, that kind of builds up a bit, you know. And that takes you even higher. It's quite good, I like that kind of build up, you know. Yeah, that's a very classic ABBA sounding song for sure. Yeah, I think the ABBA fans will be very pleased with this album. It's mad. I think they got.
I have learned to cope, and love and hope is that's why I am here now.
Oh, that's a nice ending. Love and hope is why I'm here now. That was nice. I like how the music kind of faded and it was just her voice. She's got a nice voice. You can hear the age somewhat, but a very nice voice, you know, and obviously she's going to sound older. But yeah, what was I saying? Completely forgot. But yeah, but no, that was a good song. And yeah, the album. So there's, I read there was 10, I think there's 10 new tracks. And there's going to be a tour, but it's a hologram tour, which is weird. But I guess they're too old to tour now, so maybe that's why they're doing it. And I think the holograms are going to show them young rather than old, which makes sense. Like heyday, kind of, you know, how people want to see them, I guess. And yeah, it's different. Different way of doing it. Yeah, I don't know what I think about the whole hologram thing. It's all right, it's a bit of fun, I think, now and again, you know, when bands do that kind of stuff. And a group like ABBA, seeing as they're not ones for sort of doing much, it seems to be a good way for them to do it. So yeah, I'm sure that ABBA fans are going to be real happy with that. That was a cool song. Yeah, I do prefer it. I think the other one I listened to, Still Have Faith in Me or whatever. I Still Have Faith in You, rather. That was more of a sad, I guess, element to it, and it was more like about talking about the years and kind of a bit of nostalgia. This one sounded a bit more upbeat and a bit more kind of a dance tune, you know, like Dancing Queen, all that kind of stuff, you know, that kind of upbeat feel, which ABBA are known for. So yeah, I mean, I got to say, although I'm not a fan of ABBA's music, I think that's pretty cool that they can still create music which is the same sound, you know. You'd think after all these years they might have drifted apart and been like, we don't even know how to collab anymore, how do we even get together and do this? But no, they seem to just come together and it clicked again, you know, and they're creating cool kind of music for their fans, and, you know, yeah, I think it's a good thing, and it's great, you know, that they didn't just fade away and the fans were just left with what they used to have. The fans can actually enjoy some new music, you know, which I think is fantastic, you know. So yeah, well done ABBA, and yeah, any ABBA fans, if you're into kind of that 80s sort of stuff, I've got a few tracks that sound a bit 80s and feature someone from the 80s, from Bronski Beat, John Foster, who was with Bronski Beat, John Foster. He did the song Hit That Perfect Beat, boy, you might remember. Well, he guested on my song, Future. So, yeah, if you look up on YouTube or iTunes, Spotify, all that stuff, Metal Map Future, and take a listen to that song. It's a good little dance groove kind of track, which you might enjoy. Yeah, there's lots of other music I've done, some metal as well, but that one's more 80s pop, which I think you guys who are watching would probably enjoy. So yeah, check that out, and yeah, give me a subscribe, hit the like or whatever, or don't, I don't really care. But yeah, subscribe if you can, and yeah, look forward to more from me, Metal Matt, and yeah, hope you all have a good night or evening or day or whatever time it is there. I know you've all been waiting up for this ABBA announcements today, so I'm sure you need some sleep by now, but hopefully you're ending your night on this. And yeah, anyone who's watching this in the future, you don't even know what I'm talking about, so yeah, hello to the future. I hope it's good. All the best.